Hello guys, and welcome to this video to learn about the infiltration anesthesia as a 3D tutorial. So just like our previous 3D tutorial of the inferior alveolar nerve block, following actually the same idea, so I'm also going to superimpose the roots from a CBCT on top of these pictures for you guys to understand the location of the roots and plan your infiltrations properly. But first, let's discuss about some key points. The first one you guys already have on your screen, and we actually need to retract the tissues properly, which will make the anesthesia even less painful for the patient. You guys can retract the tissues with the mirror to avoid pinching yourself with the needle, but if you use the fingers, at least you could retract a little bit more, right? So we have now two different regions, one is slightly posterior than the other, and then of course you guys should avoid the frenulum, but you guys should be able to locate this infiltration, all right? So let's understand that you are seeing now on your screen the mucogingival junction. Below this line, we have keratinized tissue of the gingiva, and on top of this line, so above this line, we have the oral mucosa, okay? But it turns out that we want our needle not exactly on the beginning of the mucosa, but on this buccal sulcus, okay? So take a look at this. This is the buccal sulcus. Anywhere close to this area would be fine for your anesthesia, okay? Because that's the area of the buccal sulcus, but it's now stretched, okay? So you now stretch the tissues because you are retracting the tissues properly, okay? For you, even for you to see properly where you are going with your needle. Then, of course, you could use topical anesthesia. You need to infiltrate your needle 2 to 3 millimeters, more or less, but let's see the location of the roots for you guys to understand a little bit better. Here would be, you know, one of the examples for you to have a very nice anesthesia of your lateral incisor. Although, if you don't retract the tissues properly, then there's a shadow, and then this could be a little bit more painful for the patient, okay? So if you retract your tissues properly, of course, it's slightly better. Then the second key point is that we need to check the needle position, right? So the bevel of the needle will be turned to the bone, just like in the previous picture. But let's see those videos now for you guys to understand the locations of the roots, okay? So the first video, I'm now superimposing the CBCT, okay? And it's just an example of a CBCT for you guys to see more or less the location of these roots, right? So, as you can see, I have the transparency of the buccal plate, and that's why you guys can see the roots, because there will be a buccal plate between the soft tissues and the roots, right? You guys are just not seeing the buccal plate, but it's there. However, it turns out that the buccal plate is porous, so you can actually release your anesthetic solution in a superperiosteum anesthesia, and this will be fine because the anesthetic solution will diffuse across the buccal plate, the buccal bone, okay? So now take a look at this arrow showing the end of the root. So you guys are seeing now the end of the root, and for a canine, you know, it would be a little bit higher than for other teeth, but usually it would be around 2 or 3 millimeters, you know, provided that you guys are retracting the tissues properly. Let's see the other video, only for us to see the superimposition of posterior teeth as well. And then, you know, those are the roots, you guys are seeing now the roots. And then we would have the position, okay? Let me draw a line here for you guys to have the position of the level of the apices of those roots, which would be, you know, the level where we find the superior posterior alveolar nerve, which comes along with the tuberosity of the maxilla, so the shape of the tuberosity, and then also the superior middle alveolar nerve, which is also in this area of premolars, right? Then the superior anterior alveolar nerve would come and then exit in through the infraorbital foramen. Here we just need to insert the anesthetic solution close to the apices, and that's fine because the bone of the maxilla is porous, right? So this is the advantage that we have here in this case. So let's understand also the locations of the nerves to talk about the palatal anesthesia, okay? So that's the CBCT of a patient. There is even an implant displaced in the maxillary sinus. Take a look at this. I'm going to talk about this case in one of the upcoming videos. But now we have an occlusal view of this maxilla, and let's now understand the location of the nerves, okay? So here we have two main important nerves for the palatal soft tissues, and those are the nasopalatine nerve from tissues between canines, so from canine to canine, the palatal soft tissues between those two teeth, so the anterior region, and then the palatal soft tissues from canine to the posterior region, so until the second and third molars, we would have the greater palatine nerve. If you take 5 millimeters, for example, from the palatal CEJ, and then you insert your needle not parallel to the teeth, but perpendicular to the bone. Okay, so that's exactly what you want to do, like this. Touch the bone and you would give a subperiosteum anesthesia, which is the correct method to give a palatal anesthesia. The buccal tissues and the teeth would be already with anesthesia due to your buccal infiltration. Okay, and then for an extraction or procedures like that, you would need the palatal anesthesia as well, because you need the palatal soft tissues to have anesthesia as well. All right. So if you guys like this video, please hit the like button and see you guys in the next videos.